Welcome to 2024, and this is Honest Wedding Advice with DJ ESG. I've been in the private event industry for 30 plus years. Over 3,500 events, weddings, sweet 16s, mitzvahs, you name it, I've done it. And this is the most honest, truthful, straight to the point wedding advice podcast you will find anywhere. There's no froofiness, there's no sugarcoating. I tell you how it is all the time. Take it or leave it. I'd rather give you the honest advice than give you some bullshit blowing smoke up your ass. But I'll tell you this, it's short, it's quick, it's to the point, and you will learn something. I'm DJ ESG, the EST of ECEG. Check out the podcast. You will not be disappointed.
What's up, guys? DJ EST dropping 30 years of knowledge and experience on you. And today, I'm talking about videographers who destroy DJ dance floor light shows with their big-ass floodlight. Yup, that's what I'm talking about today. Videographers, I love you. A lot of you guys are my friends, but you got to understand something. When a bride and groom pays all this money to have this great light show pre-programmed with moving heads and everything else that goes along with it, your big oversized washed out video light fluorescing the entire show kills us. I want to give you two examples. You go to a concert, the concert opens up, this pre-produced light show with all these awesome colors, fireworks are going off, and somebody hits it with a floodlight from across the room. What's the point of paying thousands and thousands of dollars for a light tech to put together this huge light show if you're just going to wash it out with some oversized light? If you watch wrestling, remember The Undertaker? Lights would go off, gong would hit, he'd come down the aisle, pitch black, smoke, purple. Imagine if some videographer washed out the entire entrance ramp and all of a sudden everything they were trying to accomplish with the WWE was just blown apart because you couldn't leave your light off. I know you guys have a job to do and you have to get the dance floor too and you have to make sure your video is in focus, but these big oversized lights that wash out the entire dance floor, do you understand something? When you guys do that, you not only kill the vibe of what could be on the dance floor, but you make the light show the DJ is putting out completely obsolete. You kill it, you destroy it. And people tend to leave the dance floor because they don't want to be seen and watched. So you're actually making it worse by doing this than you are by just getting a light on your camera instead of washing out the entire dance floor with some overprocessed glow that, honest to God, is unnecessary. We're all important. I get it. The DJ, the photographer, the videographer. But the vibe on the dance floor is the most important. And when you kill that vibe, it sucks. It sucks as a DJ when you guys blow up our spot. A photographer's light, it flashes on and off. They take a picture, it flashes. It goes away. It flashes. It goes away. It's a split second of light. You guys leave these things on for the entire party. Literally, I want to break them. I want to walk over and break them in half when you guys do that. If a DJ has no light show and you want to put on your light because it's too dark in the room, awesome. Do what you got to do. But if a DJ comes with a light show, it means the client paid for it and that's what they want and they want that vibe on the dance floor. Don't blow up the spot. Figure out plan B. And all you brides booking videographers, remember this. Remember this right now. If you spend hundreds of thousands of dollars on a light show and you got a videographer coming that's going to blow that light show up, what's the point? You're killing everything. You're killing your dance floor. You're killing your vibe. I'm ESG. That's my honest advice. Take it or leave it. I'll be back tomorrow. Peace, love, and God above, and I'm out. Bye-bye.
Do you have the time to listen to me whine about nothing and everything all at once? I am one of those melodramatic fools, neurotic to the bone, no doubt about it. Sometimes I give myself the creeps. Sometimes my mind plays tricks on me. It all keeps adding up. I think I'm cracking up. Am I just paranoid? Am I just stuck? I went to a shrink. Sometimes my mind plays tricks on me. It all keeps ending.